Hi fans, have all a nice evening. Today I want to pick for you a nice little round cylinder from Leon's Logpad. And Leon has called it Aimbear. Pretty cool lock, you can see the key. And Stromy told me that this key is a CES key. Let's get the vice in here. I've picked it a couple times out of interest. It's quite a nice pick and a bit tricky. But I can already tell you it's really nicely made. I've not taken it apart, I just picked it a couple times. And I will pick it with my trusty new Attila pick. And just want to share a little comparison. Here on the right side is the tone. And on the left is the Attila, and you can see here it has this nice bow on the underside. I really love this new Sparrow's picks, and I'm trying to substitute my custom picks to save them a little bit, so that we don't wear out too much, and also to use some commercial picks. Okay, let's try it. I'm tensioning it on the top of the keyway. Okay, first pin is already binding a little bit. I could see that this one is pretty high because you can see the key pin and the driver directly to a relatively open keyway. Okay, had to reset it because when I set pin 2, it dropped down a little bit. Now I'm working on pin 3. And I again heard a pin drop. And it was again pin 1. Okay. 1, 2. Not sure on 2. 3 seems okay. 4. 4 is binding now. A little click from 4. And now pin 5. Okay. Let off tension a little bit. Okay. Oh, got a very, very slight turn here. I'm pulling the pick to the front. I think I set pin 3 again. Pin 1, okay. And I got a pretty deep front set. And 1 is giving a bit more. Trying to get it up a bit higher. Okay, wow, we are in a pretty deep falsett now. So let's check what we have to set next. Okay, pin 2 is giving a bit of feedback here. Okay, check 1 is loose, very fine. 2 seems solid. 3 seems okay. 4. Now 4 gives a bit feedback. I'm letting off tension and very, very carefully try to set pin 4. I'm not in a hurry. Don't want to lose the front pins. And here we are open. Oh, I lost something. Oh. And once again, oh, this little back clip from the lock did fall off. I had it a couple of times. So I have to be a bit careful. I will bend this back clip, which goes here in the back of the lock to this little hole. I will bend it in a way that it doesn't fall out again the next time. Okay, oh, my microphone cable dropped down, sorry. Okay, as always, not prepared. I actually have to look which follower to use. Pins are on the right side. And I hope I'm somehow getting... don't want to close it. I'm not sure how I get this end piece off. I will try to use a bit force here. Okay. It's pressed on pretty tight, but you can see it is separating here. Wiggling it off very careful. Oh, it sits pretty tight. Carefully going back and forth. Let's check. Oh, it's still tied on. Oh, have to be careful not again to cut my fingers. Okay, so the end piece is off. Very nice. Pins are on the right side. Oh. This is an unusual end piece. I will definitely use a shim. Okay. Oh. Okay. Shim goes in nicely after a little catch there. I'm not sure what follower to use. Let's see if I have something. Maybe this carbon. Looks a little bit too small. I think I will use this follower here and hope for the best that the shim bridges it nicely. Okay, worked. Can see a little 5-pin lock here. All pins are nice down. One is very, very deep down. And zoom in for you a bit. We have a threading on chamber one. Only 2 threads. We have a bit threading on 2, 3. And almost looks like a little bit threading on 4 also and 5. Not sure. We will see close up in a second. Okay, let's dump out the pins. We have a standard in 1. We have a single serrated key pin in 2. I have to look this closer in a second. Looks like a serrated T-pin or a serrated spool. Okay, we have a standard in 4. And we have a standard in 5. I'm still not sure. No, there's no undercutting. There's just a single thread. Maybe you can see it. Here. Very cool. Nice little core. okay, let's get the shim out. And try to pull out the drivers here. One. I would say it has very... Oh! It is a pin and pin. I first didn't see it. It is a pin and pin. It has fine serrations here on this part. Very interesting. Let's dump a spring out. If I can get it out, maybe I have to use a smaller pick here. A very tiny spring. It looks like a steel spring, okay. Still in frame, that's nice. Oh, we have a... I'm not sure, I would say it is a spool. It was in like this, with a very sharp rim. It has a copper spring, or very tiny spring. Number 3. It's double serrated, very cool, and another little copper spring, and we have a very deep spool in 4. This is probably the deep falsett came from, and we have a half steel spring in 4 and in 5. There is, oh, again a pin and pin. I pulled out the top part here. Oh, this is interesting. Spring is stuck here in the end. Just looking at the core. I think there's nothing done to the Bible, okay? There's nothing done to the Bible, it is smooth. Let's have a closer look at the pins here. I will turn it sideways. For you as always. I hope you can see nicely. It's not easy to get the focus point here. Okay, in one, as I said, standard keeping, serrated keeping in two. This looks pretty interesting. Yes, it is a T-pin with a very slight serration. Four is actually not a keypin, this is a driver. Doesn't have a pointy end. And five is a standard keypin again. And we have, it's very hard to see as these pins are so tiny. Yes, we have a pin and pin. The inside part is not serrated and the outside part has, I would say a couple scratches, not really serrations. Was in like this, I would say some scratches. Driver number two, this is a little spool with a very sharp rim. Driver three is a double serrated one, very nicely and deeply made serrations. Number four, driver number four, a very deep spool here. And driver number five is again a pin and pin. not really serrations, but I would say some scratches on this part, which goes to the keypin, and also some scratches on the spring part here. The spring, okay, the hole is a little bit big, so the spring was stuck a little bit in this, but no problem. Very cool. pretty nice to pick lock. Sometimes it can trick you. I think this serration on keypin number two can get you really stuck, and also the T-pin end here on keypin number three, not that easy to handle. Quite a fun lock to pick. Thanks a lot, Leon. Please check out Leon's lockpad. Pretty nice channel. Yeah, thank you all for watching, and see you in the next picking video. Bye.